know, there's something very familiar about Iceland. Couldn't you even put my finger on it? And then when I got there, I went over to the farm to ride one of those Icelandic ponies. The ones with the enormous heads and four gates. All trot cantering, basically flight. Now the farm had belonged to Iceland's most famous writer, Halldór Laxness. And his book was called Independent People. And it's a description of this huge, empty lunar landscape. And nothing much happens in the book. Sheep get horrible intestinal diseases. Shepherds stare at the walls of their huts for months on end. Father and his daughter stop speaking, and they gradually lose track of each other and wander off into the distance. And everybody really loves this book. It's really very, very popular in Iceland. Anyway, I went to the farm to ride the ponies, and I was talking to the guy who ran the barn, and he was showing me around the place. And right behind the barn was the enormous ramshackle ruin, just a massive, miserable mud hovel. Rotting rafters, caved-in walls. Like some huge mud bowling alley. And he was really excited. He was saying, you know, he's planning to fix it up for barn dances and parties. It's going to be amazing, he said. Everyone from all around there is going to be coming. And I looked out at the barren countryside, gray nothingness to the blank horizon. And I thought, this guy is delusional. I mean, this just does not look like a party place. I mean, people just don't do that kind of thing, you know, in ghost towns. But he kept doing this, winking. There was a wink at the end of practically every sentence, like a period or an exclamation point. And then he said, you know, but once we open the place, you never know whether the elves are going to come or not. And then he winked again. Okay, now all this winking was really putting me off. Plus this crazy, unrealistic enthusiasm. But the whole time I'm thinking, now why is this so familiar? What does this remind me of? And then I realized, I'd heard this exact same story before from my father, who had a farm in Chicago. And he had this exact same plan to convert a huge wreck of a bar into a dance hall. And he had the same crazy, relentless enthusiasm. And he was doing this constant winking too. And I thought, wait a second. Who are these people? Now, just a little background. My father was the son of an orphan named Axel, who made his way down through Canada to Chicago. And since he was speaking what sounded quite a lot like Swedish, we assumed that we might be Swedish too, and we were all very happy to be from somewhere, you know, definite. However, Axel also said he had arrived by himself in Chicago when he was 9, got married when he was 10, and he had his first son when he was 12. But Axel was either really, really precocious or else he was a liar. His real story lost forever somewhere. Along the way. Now on the other side of the family, the Irish side, the stories were also really very, very Recently somebody told me that Pikmin ice are made up of two branches with that kind of twine together. The Vikings and the Irish missionary monks. And since that's my own heritage, more or less, Swedish and Irish, I suddenly realized why that pony farm had seemed so familiar. Iceland was a combination of both of those groups. Both people who tend to see things out of the corners of their eyes. Elves, 30-foot tall, thunder gods. And you know how you hope your ancestors might have been sophisticated counts or scribes? And then you find that your actual ancestors were lonely, incestuous shepherds. Too drunk to leave their huts, or wandering lost out in the moors, fabricators, hallucinators. Their beautiful sockets, their stories of elves and sea cows, all twisted together into a huge book that's a combination of the idiot. Burnt down, abandoned house, or a bare coastline in the middle of nowhere.